forward and back. Trying to loosen everything up. Three, four, and five. Okay, around. One, two, three, four. And try to keep your arms as straight as you can. That's how you know you're getting good mobility between that ball socket of the shoulder. Four and five. And then we're going to do an external rotation with the band. So essentially, you need to put this on something and you're going to extend out, rotate out. And the key is you want to keep that elbow locked in to your rib cage, but keep the shoulder back for posture and rotate out. So you can simply do this and see how you do. If you're not parallel to your body, as far as here, and you're ending right about here, and that's as far as you can go, don't add a band, okay? So start here, posture in the shoulders, keep the chest tall, and try to keep those elbows right at your side. So we're gonna do this today, just to make sure you have good rotation, and this will warm up that ball socket. I think we're on about six. Quality movement, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Okay, now I do want you to tie your band. You can have a handled band if you would like. I'm gonna go back to the rig and loop it around. Show you what we're doing. So anchor your band. You're gonna have the arm straight up. And I want you to pull it down, control, let it go back. It should feel like it's stretching that lat and pulling the arm behind you in a good stretch. If it doesn't, take a step forward, okay? Shoulder down, arm is straight. Pull the band down, should feel your lat engage and your core. Let it stretch back, pull down, using that lat and the core. Control the back, let it stretch. So we're doing an active stretch and muscle engagement. Get one more on this side and we'll switch. Everything's controlled. All right, switch the arms. So I start in that up position, drop the shoulder down, take a step forward, pull down with that lat and my core, control the band going back, let the arm and the shoulder stretch. My neck is neutral, I'm just looking straight. Control the back, let it stretch, lat engage, core engage, pull it back down, come on three, we have two more, stretch, lat engagement, pull it down, control the back, four, last one. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to be doing is a seated dumbbell shoulder overhead press. The ending position, you want your bicep to be by your ear. So from here, if you're not able to get a straight arm, then you really need to work on your mobility. Recommend doing it at least every time you go to warm up to do a workout. Okay? All right, so we have three sets of seated single arm overhead press. And you're going to be doing anywhere from 8 to 15 reps. The second movement is a low to high chop. Okay, so sit tall with posture. All the way up, one, two, full range of motion. That bell should come back down to your shoulder. The elbow is right in front of you. Three, as I'm doing this, I'm keeping my core tight. I'm not leaning. Four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, I think I found my weight. All right, posture in the shoulders. I put my other arm out to stabilize myself. Okay. All right, post. One, two, three, four, five, stay tall, six, seven, and eight. All right. Again, it's 8 to 15. So if you don't have a weight that is hard to get to 8, you're going further up with your reps. Okay, low to high chop. Find your dumbbell or a ball. You're gonna do a squat, posture in the shoulders. So in this position, I'm in a deadlift position, active stance. I'm gonna go up and over my shoulder, come right back down. All right, so we have 8 to 15. I am doing 8. For the video. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Other side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Okay. Check our time, make sure we're doing good. Yep, we're on schedule. Okay, if you need a break, water, whatever it is, grab it. We have two more sets. Here we go. Okay, posture, shoulders down. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, one more, eight. Obviously, I'm starting with my harder side or my weaker side. Okay, here we go. One, two, bell touches my shoulder. Three, full range of motion. Four, five, six, seven, 8. Ooh, I can tell I've been painting. My shoulders are tired. That's okay. It's all good. Okay. Boost them up. Remember, your reps are 8 to 15. We're working for strength. So if your bands are stronger than your dumbbell weight, you can add them together. Band. It's up to you. All right. Low to high chop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. I was going to 8. Oh well, 2 extra. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, we have one more set. All right, I'm going for 8. We'll see what I get. Remember, quality movement. You don't want the path of least resistance to be leaning. You want to stay tight and strong. Okay. Starting at the shoulder. 1, 2, 3. 5, 6. We're getting 6. Oh, goodness. All right, posture, brace in the core. Posture, brace the core, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Shoulders are burning. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay, we have every minute on the minute, and it's for 6 to 10 minutes. You decide how long you're gonna go. We have good mornings and band pull apart. So a couple reminders with the good mornings. We're working on shoulder mobility. So if you have great mobility, you can use a barbell with this. If not, you're gonna use a broomstick because you have to be able to get the shoulders back. That's where this movement comes in play really well, okay? You might wanna think about putting a broomstick in the corner of your bedroom before you climb in bed. Do five halos around the head, the whole thing. Wake up, do it again. The only way you get good at something is practice. Okay, positioning. This is the positioning of where you want your bar. You don't want it up here on the neck, okay, or the traps right here. You want it right below. There's a nice sweet spot right there. We call it a shelf. When you have weight, it works really well to sit there and not move. So you are going to just do a standard stance. So hip width apart with your feet. Keep the bar here, elbows down, chest tall. Look straight ahead, brace the core. I'm going to hinge and push my glute back. My back is flat. In this position, I can feel my hamstrings, the back of the leg, stretching. I'm going to squeeze my bottom, push my hips forward, squeeze at the end. Hinge. Back is flat. Come down only to what your flexibility is, but the positioning you're wanting is right. Squeeze the glute, push the hips forward. Squeeze the glutes again hard. All right, so that is a good morning. And you're gonna do the stick, the barbell, or barbell with weight. But it all is dictated on your shoulder mobility for the capability of doing it correctly, okay? So, going to go on the clock, and then band pull apart. You guys all know that. You start here, drop the shoulders, pull the band apart. You want the rubber band to hit you underneath the chest. And as I'm doing this, my feet are together. I'm contracting my quads, squeezing my glute, bracing my core. So everything in the lower half is activated. All right, so let me get a band. And we are gonna do a total of 6 minutes. And I'm just gonna do the broomstick with you so you get really good at the basics. Once you're great at the basics, that's when you can expand and get super strong. Okay, timer. Every minute on the minute. So I'm gonna face this way so you can actually see the movement. Good morning is first. In 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, good positioning. Find that shelf. Ab is braced. In the hamstring, neck is neutral, so I'm not looking ahead. Looking down at the floor, neck, neutral neck. Push the hips forward, squeeze the bottom. Hinge. Squeeze. 2. Actually, I don't need to count. 3. I think it's habit. Keep bracing that core. Sometimes can be a challenge, but that's when you know your core is getting super strong. Okay, our minute is up. We're going directly into band pull apart. I'm going to put my feet together, squeeze my legs, my glute, core is tight, drop the shoulders, pull the band apart, control the end. Keep squeezing the glute, pushing the legs together. You want contraction of everything. Neck is bobblehead loose. Don't tighten up the neck. You essentially want from your shoulders down, tight. We have 12 seconds and we go back into the broomstick. Okay, that's top of the minute again. Positioning. Hinge. Get those elbows down. You don't want to flare them back. Bracing the core. So in doing this movement, quality movement, just know if I had weight on me, I would not be moving this quick. Okay, top of the minute again, back to your band. If you need to build in rest, you do it. Okay, so shoulders down, squeeze the legs. You should be doing pinching those shoulder blades back and squeezing, working the rear delt, squeeze the legs, the glute, tighten it all up. Okay, band goes down, get your broomstick. It's our last set. You can always do more. This time I'm going to do sumo position. Everything is the same. I'm just positioning in sumo. Bracing the core, back is flat, neck is neutral. Weight stays driven through the heel as I go up and down. Ten more seconds. Last set with the band. Sorry for the sniffles. It's cold in here. My body's warm, but my nose thinks differently. All right, contracting everything. Bobblehead, shoulders down, feel those lats. I'm keeping tension on the band the entire time. That's why I'm not coming all the way in and giving it slack. Time under tension. Feeling like I'm pinching the lower part of my shoulder blades, pushing my quads together, squeezing my bottom, bracing my core. Almost there, 10 more seconds. Shoulders are burning. Okay. Okay, time. All right, we're going into the Turkish getup. So with the Turkish getup, I have separate videos that are on YouTube breaking it apart. So we're gonna start on the floor and work our way up. I'm not gonna use weight. I'm just gonna move through the movements with you. Right heel, I can see it on the outside of my hip. Right arm goes up. Make a fist like you're holding a dumbbell or a kettlebell. I'm gonna go up to the elbow on my left, chest tall. Keep this arm as tall and towards the ceiling as possible at all times. Now I wanna watch my kettlebell, so whatever's in my hand, I wanna keep an eye on. Go up to the hand. I'm gonna high bridge. Sweep that left knee through by my wrist. Come up. I'm gonna windshield wiper my back heel. Pull my front one in a little bit. So I'm in a half kneeling position. I'm gonna stand up. From here, I'm gonna reverse it. Lunge back. Control to the floor. Windshield wiper that back leg. Hinge. Kettlebell, sweep the hand, weight goes in the heel and the hand, high bridge through to sit down, control to the elbow, all the way to the floor. Okay, let's do this one more time on the other side now. We haven't been working on the left at all, so let's work on the left. Okay, bend the left knee, left hand goes up. You need to be able to see me. I'm gonna face this way, so I think you can see my entire body this way. Okay, see how I can see my heel, my left hand, right one's out. Push through that left heel, ab is braced, chest tall. Ceiling with my left hand, high bridge, right knee goes by my right wrist. Come up. I'm going to windshield wiper this back leg. Bring my front in front of me, so I'm in a half kneeling. Stand up. So in this position, I'm now going to reverse it. So I'm going to step back with my right, got my left hand up in the air, control the knee down, windshield wiper that back leg, hinge, look at my bell, sweep, transfer the weight, see how my hands are straight up and down. If I put a broomstick in against it, it would be completely straight. That's what you're looking for. I don't want to be over here. Straight up and down. Transfer the weight to that left heel, right hand. Pull the leg through. Control to the elbow. Keep this hand here. Control down with your abs. All right, if you're struggling with that, I want you to go to the YouTube channel, and I've got it broken apart into three positions. So you're working on the lower part, then you're standing, going to the reverse, and then you're doing the whole thing. So part one, part two, and part three on the YouTube Better for Life. So practice it, because using this, it's a full body movement, cardiovascular, strength, mobility, flexibility. It's everything. Super good for you. All right.